WeatherWatch 12, brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. The future in trucks is here. The all-new 2014 Chevy Silverado delivers where you need it. Strength, towing, payload, torque, and fuel efficiency. It works as hard as you do. Go with the leader. Go with Chevy.
Hi there, and thanks for clicking on WISN.com. I'm meteorologist Chris Gloninger with this web weather update. We're missing out on a frost and freeze. Just to the northwest, we have frost advisors and freeze warnings up to the northern side of Wisconsin. The reason why we're not going to get as cold as our neighbors to the north is because we're holding on to some cloud cover right along the lakeshore, and we do have a bit of a light breeze, and that will keep numbers up into the upper 30s and low 40s. The clouds starting to dissipate and move out, but we do have clear skies and light winds north of La Crosse all the way up to Eau Claire, and that's the air mass that we're expecting for us as we go into tomorrow night. On Monday, we're at 63, 68 on Tuesday, a hop into the 70s on Wednesday and Thursday, and that will likely continue into Friday and Saturday. So we start off fall below average, and we're ending the week with numbers into the 5 to 10 degree above average range, I think, for most areas across southeast Wisconsin. Temperatures tonight down to the 40s from Sheboygan through Port Washington, Milwaukee, Racine, and Kenosha. Mid-30s from West Bend through Beaver Dam, Janesville, Lake Geneva. A little bit cooler there, Watertown, 35 degrees, your low temperature tonight. As we go into the first day of fall, we're expecting temperatures into the low 60s right up along the lakeshore, Kenosha, Racine, into Milwaukee, upper 50s in West Bend, Madison out towards our state's capital, and the Dells around 63, 64 in Janesville. So you see the satellite showing the clouds starting to push their way off the lakeshore, and as we go into the next couple of hours, we'll see those clouds, I think, fall apart altogether. So we maintain clear skies, but it's that light wind that will keep our temperatures from dropping to 35 or 38 degrees when we start to see widespread frost. High pressure building in, and that is the key weather player in our forecast for the next several days. That is why our storm threat is at a zero for the next 5 days. Our next chance for wet weather comes up on next Saturday with the cold front that does move through. Again, high pressure means sunshine Monday right through next Friday. 50 at 9 o'clock, widespread 40s at that hour. Noontime, as the run in Veterans Park winds down, we'll see a temperature 56, 60 at 4 o'clock. Monday, Tuesday, we start that climb into the mid-60s, high 60s, then mid-70s for Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Saturday down slightly, but still muggy with showers and storms returning with that cold front. Hey, thanks for checking us out here at WISN.com, your next web update hosted by Sal in the morning.